What's the league? What's the league chatter about the
interesting? I mean, I think look, I'm from the I spent most of my adult life in the great state of Missouri, and we know it's the show me state. So I think that's kind of how everyone is. It's like, I think everyone's excited about to see Joey Burrow, because I know I am, because what he did at LSU. Now they had a stacked team and this and that, but to see some of the plays he made and the way he navigated things, it is such an NFL style of football. And the way he handles himself, and look, the Bengals cupboard is not bare. It's not like he is going to an absolute crap team. They were 2-14 last year. Right. The wheels came off. But there is some talent on this football team.
Yeah.
So can they get by the Steelers? Can they get by the Ravens? Can they get by the Browns? That's the tough challenge. But I don't think this is something where we're saying Joe Burrow is just going, into Siberia.
Right.
I think there's an opportunity for the Bengals to really be a competitive football team. Are they a playoff football team? I don't know, because of the three teams I named above them.
Right, that's right.
And that's the really tough thing.
Yeah, that's the one thing I think, and you're right, Steve, you hit it on the head, the cupboard is not bare, not only offensively, where we know about Joe Mixon, maybe we don't know about Joe Mixon. I think he's one of the quiet guys in the league. He's been the MVP of this team the last 2 years when AJ's been out. So you get him, and I always tell Mixon this stat. There have been five games when he's had 20 carries and AJ has played, and they're 5-0. So they finally get teamed up again with John Ross, who's an intriguing guy, obviously. So Burrow's got people to throw to. But defensively, they remade that defense in free agency with at every level. Von Bell's going to be a factor at safety.
I love him.
Yeah, he's mentally and physically, the guy is a lift to this team. Josh Bynes in the middle, classic run-stopping traffic cop middle linebacker, which they need. And then the two tackles up front to give him attitude and talent, DJ Reader and Mike Daniels. So they're completely remade. They aren't the 32nd defense anymore. They might not be the Mike Zimmer-esque sixth, but they can certainly sniff at 18, 17, and 16.
I knew you were not going to make it through here without mentioning Zim. You had to mention Zim.
Mike Zimmer-esque.
Zimmer-esque. Look, they're a team that's going to have to stop the run. When you look at this division, the Browns are coming at you with Nick Chubb. Okay? We know what the Ravens are going to do, and we know what the Steelers are going to do. They're going to have to stop the run. So some of the guys you mentioned, run stoppers, guys who can really hit the edges and make plays, but they are going to have to be so solid in their fundamentals, right, because of guys like Lamar Jackson, because of, Kareem Hunt and Nick Chubb.
Yeah.
It's – so, look, I do think they're going to be better. So much of it depends on the fact they cannot turn the ball over on offense, put their defense in a bad situation. Defense got to get takeaways. That's the name of the game in the NFL now. You get takeaways, give your offense the ball. Even if you've got to kick field goals all game, you give yourself a shot.
Yeah.
So that's part of it. They stop the run and get takeaways. I think Burrow is going to be a fun player to watch, man. Again, I think it's going to be a competitive squad.
Yeah.